This problem is a degree of freedom analysis on a column, which we'll draw like this. And we have one flow rate that we're going to call m.1 that's coming in kilograms per hour. The mass fraction of B is 0.03, and the rest going in to this stream is C. Then we have a second stream coming in, which is 5,300 kilograms per hour, and it consists of A and B. And note my nomenclature. It's totally up to you how you want to do it, but when I put in the mass fractions, I start it with the stream number, like X1, and then followed by what the species is. So exiting the column, we have a mass flow rate that I'm going to call M3, and it consists of only A. Then from the middle of the column, I have a mass flow rate of 1,200 kilograms per hour that has a mass fraction of 0.7A, then some mass fraction of B, and some mass fraction of C. From the bottom of the column, we have some flow rate that we're going to call M5, and it has a mass fraction of 0.6, that's B, and the rest of this is C. And we're going to do a degree of freedom analysis on the system to see how many degrees of freedom we have, or if any information needs to be supplied in order to solve for our unknowns. So the first thing we're going to do is count up the unknowns. So take a look, and if we look at the flow rates, we have M1, M3, and M5 that we don't know. If we look at the mass fractions, we have X1C, we have X2A, we have X2B, X4B, X4C, and X5C. So when we count them up, we find that we have 9 unknowns. So let's see how many independent species balances we can make. We have 3 species, A, B, and C, so we can make 3 independent species balances, which would be A, B, and C. Instead, we could do an overall balance and 2 of the species balances, but we can't do all 4 overall A, B, and C because they are not independent. In addition, we have some extra information, and that is that we can sum up all the mole fractions in stream 1. And that has to equal 1. All the mole fractions in stream 2, and that has to equal 1. All the mole fractions in stream 4, and that has to equal 1. And finally, all the mole fractions in stream 5 have to equal 1. Why did I not do the same for stream 3? Well, if you go back and look at the picture, what you see is that stream 3 is completely A, so there's no other mole fractions. So now let's look at this. We have 9 unknowns. We subtract from that our 3 independent species balances. We subtract from that our 4 pieces of extra information, and we end up with 2 degrees of freedom. That means in order to solve this problem, we need 2 more pieces of information. Now, one thing that we can do to make it easier is use those constraints that sum of the mass fractions has to equal one to already solve for some of our unknowns. So we'll start with x1c. And again, let's go to this picture. And if you notice that we have 3% b, so since c is the only other one, this has to equal 0.97. In stream two, we know neither of the mole fractions, but we can write x2a in terms of x2b. Now when we look at stream four, you'll notice that we have a, b, and c, but we can write either x4b or x4c in terms of the other unknown. So let's write that as x4b equals 1 minus 0.7, which is the mass fraction of a, minus the mass fraction of c. So this equals 0.3 minus x4c. And finally, in stream 5, we can figure out x5c by just subtracting that 0.6 from 1, and this has to equal 0.4. So we've solved for four of our unknowns, so the number of unknowns has become 5. Does this mean that the number of degrees of freedom have changed? And the answer is no, because we've used our four pieces of extra information. So we have zero of those. So now we have 5 minus 3 minus 0 still equals 2 degrees of freedom.